began to burn. It attracted all sorts of beings and entities. The fire created light and dark, up and down, and gave energy to all life forms. The elusive and gripping strength of the flame attracted and demanded someone to harness its derivative. Its location resided in a flat and open bedrock atmosphere, rocks a few. Scarce entities reached and harnessed the fire's souls. One must be a wearer of the ancient fire pendant to gain the fire's power. The great Balrog, a large demonic beast with a blue flaming tree as a blunt weapon, led the goblin army to forge their kingdom from the fire's energy. The spectacular witch, Ellis, brought carnage and spells, along with her witch apprentices, to the epic battle. The ember-driven giant Spelina and his spear-throwing family also fought. Finally, the elite group of Wilhelm soldiers, led by the ferocious bearded Ganglimir and their royal steel equipment, charged. The four armies collided from all angles, heading towards the flame. All energy collided in one instant, as all four leaders lunged for the flame simultaneously. At once, a large beam of light struck their hands and the floating pendant in the flame. The pendant was broken by the beam and forced into four shards. Each leader grabbed their own shard and ran away into darkness. The flame was no longer. Kael arose from a coffin in the deep Farren swamp, lifted from the enchantment placed upon him, keeping him in a deep slumber for centuries. The fire has disappeared and all life in Eldrian has gone to havoc. Humans become corroded, meaning they have no soul left over. Their soul, which is driven by the flame, is no longer. All mankind has become corroded, except Kael. He awakes from his slumber and finds a note in his pocket. The note revealed four clues about the four shard bearers scattered across Eldrian. The first clue led him to the ancient ruins of Eldrian, as it read in Eldrian's ruins, "Shadows speak. A chamber holds the clue you seek." Kael felt a sense of great burden as he held humanity's sheer existence in his hands. This required a great load of focus and confidence. Being a forgotten soldier for a long-lost kingdom, he was noticeably weary about his adventure. He supposed his sister, Annabel, had cast him asleep centuries ago with the unique voodoo magic she was born with. He carried on to the ancient ruins of Eledrian from the Farren swamp, hustling over ashy logs and mud and through thick fog. Eventually, he arrived at the ancient ruins. There were crumbled yellow pillars and a large being sat in the middle of the church remnants. It was the great Balrog. Kael swiftly walked being him, looking to kill him whilst Balrog was asleep. However, Balrog's body felt his presence and shot straight up into the sky, exploding his entire body and weapon in flames. Balrog screamed and yelled in aches of his long nap. Goblins arose from the surrounding mud and tree huts, beginning to overwhelm Kael. He knew he was sure to die if he didn't pull some elaborate moves soon. He read aloud another note his sister had left him, one for special emergencies. Requiem Aeternum. The great Balrog shrieked as a holy light shined above, blasting all goblins to oblivion. The great Balrog was struck next, stunning him to the ground, leaving time for Kael to perform a riposte into his shining red eyes. He did so, and the great Balrog's entire body evaporated, leaving one of the four shards in the place of his body. Kael grabbed the shining fiery shard of the flame amulet and placed it on his necklace rope. He instantly felt more powerful and his heart soared. He then discovered a young girl hovering over an ashen campfire. He walked over and talked to her, discovering that she was an ancient spirit, looking for someone to rekindle the souls of many. She described that her name was Meryl and instructed Kael to press his shard on the campfire. The campfire magically lit up, and Meryl explained that he was now able to teleport to other campfires across Eldrian. Meryl also provided a map of all campfire locations, as well as all amulet shard locations. Kael chose to teleport to the Veiled Woods, where the witch Ellis resided in her house on the hillside. He quickly charged to her home, breaking down the door, and smashing all witchcraft he could lay his eyes on. He could not find Ellis until she appeared behind him, shrieking as a witch does. She teleported around him, whilst casting spells Kael had to dodge. Kale memorized her patterns and pre-fired one of her teleportation spots, stabbing her in the neck with his long Zweihander. Similar to Balrog, her body disappeared, and her remembrance resembled the next amulet shard. The amulet shard had a sort of magnetic pull toward Kale's necklace. Kale reached down to pick it up, and the shard connected to his necklace by itself. Kale felt even stronger, as if he'd gained more prestige, and lit another campfire. He then teleported to the giant graveyard, in hopes of finding and defeating the giant Spelina. There were spears and arrows, hundreds of feet in height, sticking out of the ground. Various golems and giants slept about, but Spelina stood out. He rests atop the great ash volcano of Yore. Kale silently sneaks through the graveyard of stone giants and mud golems, some alive and some wheezing. He began to climb up the volcano's hillside and accidentally stepped on a loose boulder. The boulder rolled down the volcano's side and hit a sleeping giant's head. The giant screamed in agony and all enemies arose in anger. Kale scrambled to the top of the volcano, dodging spears and arrows thrown by the stone giants. He got to the top of the volcano and discovered that Spelina was waiting for him in his mansion. Spelina's manor was covered in thick blood from the walls to the floor. Kale trudged through the blood, getting deeper and darker into the manor. Spelina came amidst the darkness and lit the golden chamber up with his eyes. Spelina swung and jumped at Kale, to no avail. Kale maneuvered and ran around the arena, dodging each attack with ease. Spelina's armor was as thick as dragon scales, though. Kale had to think out of the box. He swung from a golden chandelier and kicked Spelina in the nose, sending him falling backward, ultimately into the volcano below. The third shard teleported into Kale's right hand and then attached itself to the pre-existing amulet. Kale lit another campfire and gained more strength as a reward. The fourth and final boss, Ganglimir, resided in the Wilhelm Castle, full of steel and armor. Kale teleported there and examined its entire exterior. He found a small back door intended for trash removal that was guarded by two centaurs. Kale hid in the rocks and listened to their conversations. He realized that they were quite dumb and threw a pebble at the castle's wall near them. They both walked away from the door to investigate. Kale then swiftly snuck into the castle's walls. He then found a ladder that led to Ganglimir's bathroom. Kale hid in the bathroom whilst Ganglimir yelled at his servants. Kale then snuck into Ganglimir's room, surprising him. Ganglimir always kept a sword on him, though, and swung on Kale out of nowhere. Kale's ring finger was torn off by the blade. Kale was persistent in his fighting, however, and managed to land a parry on Ganglimir. Ganglimir fell backward, allowing Kale to perform a riposte, one that he was familiar with now. Finally, Ganglimir's heart stopped from Kale's sword, and the final piece to the amulet was fulfilled. At last, the amulet rose from his neck, breaking the rope that connected the necklace, and flew out of a window. Moments later, the sky was filled with fire and warmth. The fire had been rekindled. The sky became blue and color returned to the land. Animals came out from their ashy burrows, and most importantly, humanity was restored. Souls were replenished and many rose from the dead. Ghosts and corroded alike were brought back to life and the world was saved. The world beings named Kale the Lord of Ash, and he now resides in the newly founded castle of Kale, months after the original fire kindling.